Greetings. This video refutes argument number 4 from the silly flood list sent by a follower of Muhammad. Let's look at the claim. According to the Word of God, the Bible, the fact that Virgin Mary gave birth to Jesus by the Holy Spirit was revealed to only one man, Joseph, her fiancé, Matthew 1:20. But according to Muhammad's Quran, her virginity was made clear to all people, Quran 19:29. So the point of this claim is that the Quran is somehow better than the Bible, because the Bible records that only Joseph knew Mary was the virgin prophesied by Isaiah. But the Quran claims that knowledge was more widespread. This is a pretty subtle issue to consider, because the knowledge of Mary fulfilling the prophet Isaiah's words is not central to either religion. The core issue is that prophet Isaiah said that this would be the sign from God, a virgin would conceive. Isaiah 7:14. Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Pay attention to this. Isaiah did not say the sign would be that all men would know in advance who the virgin is. So, given the virgin birth, who would need to know, and when would they need to know it? Joseph certainly needed to know. He was about to marry a woman who he found out would be pregnant before he was intimate with her, Matthew 1:20. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost, or the Holy Spirit. Now this verse also creates problems for Islam, and I'm going to talk about those in another video. So Joseph definitely needed to know. He needed to know before they got married, so that he would marry Mary and stay with her. Joseph needed to know she had not been sinful. But other than Joseph, who actually needed to know beforehand that Mary was the virgin? Literally, no one. No one needed to know. Consider the following. The three wise men were coming to worship the Messiah, predicted by the star of Bethlehem. What did King Herod want to know? He wanted to know where this new king would be born. And he asked his advisors. And what was Herod thinking? Herod was threatened by the news of a new king. Herod found out the king would be born in Bethlehem. Herod ordered every boy under 2 years of age killed in Bethlehem. So does it make any sense to think that God needs to announce specifically who the virgin is before his son is born into the world? God told you where the child would be born, in Bethlehem. And see what happened. Herod used that information to try and destroy the Son of God. Whether you believe he's the Son of God or only a prophet, Herod used that information to try and destroy this child born of a virgin, this sign from God. So no, it does not make sense that God would need to say specifically who the virgin is. In fact, if God had revealed Mary was the virgin prophesied by Isaiah, Herod would likely have continued killing until he had killed Mary as well as Jesus. Besides that, there are already several prophecies concerning Jesus' birth that are sufficient to prove he is the Son of God. Isaiah 7:14. Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. Micah 5:2, "But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times." This is the verse that Herod's scholars found to say that the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem. And the consequence of Herod knowing the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem was that Herod ordered all the baby boys killed, all of them that were under 2 years of age. And this fulfilled Jeremiah 31:15. This is what the Lord says, "A voice is heard in Ramah, mourning and great weeping, Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because her children are no more." Now, this is Matthew 2:13. "Now when they," the Magi, "had gone, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, 'Get up, take the child and his mother and flee to Egypt, and remain there until I tell you, for Herod is going to search for the child to destroy him.'" Matthew 2:14. "So he got up, took the child and his mother during the night and left for Egypt, where he stayed until the death of Herod. And so was fulfilled what the Lord had said through the prophet, 'Out of Egypt I called my son.'" The news of the virgin birth was taught to his disciples during Jesus' time on earth, specifically after his crucifixion and his resurrection. Then Jesus taught his disciples about all the prophecies concerning him. Luke 24:27, "And beginning at Moses, with the prophecy of Deuteronomy 18, and all the prophets, he," Jesus, "expounded unto them all the scriptures, the things concerning himself." So getting back to this Islamic claim, number four, does this claim have any merit? Not really. But I have a question for all who say they are Muslim. Does God have to perform for your approval? Then why does your religion seem to teach you and train you to judge God with arguments like this one? Once you truly decide to submit to God, you will stop judging His word in the Torah and Psalms and Bible. Until then, you make yourself God's judge, and you are your own Allah. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who was born of the Virgin. Amen.